Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back to another episode of Aqua's Adventure. Today we're going to have lots of fun. We're going to be doing some building and making the place look a bit nicer. You can see the little list right here. Today we're going to be building a fountain. We're going to be making a little armor dispensary, and we're going to be making the place look nicer by replacing the stone bricks with some of the bone blocks, which in my opinion will look nicer a little bit. So guys, yeah, hopefully today we're going to have some fun. Hopefully you guys are going to enjoy watching it, and let's get started. Okay, so we're going to be starting with the first one, which is building the fountain. Now, I've actually already gathered the materials, and I broke a bunch of ores to help us with this. But yeah, I already did all the material gathering. All we have to do is actually build the fountain itself. And I want to show you a couple things real quickly. Let's head outside because I did start on it a little bit, so we're not completely blind. So this is exactly where the fountain is going to go. I'm not exactly sure how high it is. It's depending on how much material I have and everything. And I'll show you guys that right now. So this is the material I have, so you guys can see kind of a general theme of blue. So I have, I did a lot of resource gathering. I actually had to go to the ocean monument and get some more things, but I did gather some more of the dark prismarine, some more of the normal prismarine, and some sea lanterns, so I had to go farm a couple of those. I also brought over some bone blocks, maybe some snow, some quartz stairs, some packed ice. I had to go get some of that too. Maybe some polished andesite. So these are kind of the general materials we're going to be using. I also go ahead and broke, I think a stack of diamond ore, and I went ahead and got that. I also took some ore from my chest. But yeah, this is kind of how big the fountain is going to be. So what I'm planning to do is, from the middle, obviously go up, and at the top, we're going to put water, obviously. And it's going to end up flowing down around these edges right here. And then during the night, hopefully this will light it up. And we'll have some sea lanterns in there while we go up. But yeah, before we actually get started, I do want to show you guys something. So I don't want to go into this completely blind. I'm going to obviously just build it freehand. But the thing is, I did set up kind of like something that I wanted to look at. So this is going to be weird, but we're actually going to be switching worlds real quick. Alright, so we are in my creative world, actually, and I went ahead and built this fountain right here. So I know this might look a little bit crazy, because obviously it is a bit crazy, and I'm just going to go ahead and put water where it's supposed to go. So this is, I took maybe an hour or two and went ahead and built this, and this is kind of what I imagined a fountain to be. Obviously, it's not going to look this nice in the world, to be honest, because I mean, I can fly here, I have unlimited materials, but this is kind of what I made on this creative world. So I'm hoping to replicate something like this in the survival world. So let's go back and, yeah, I guess we can just start building. Now, the only thing is, this building is going to take quite a while. Even on my creative world, it took an hour or two. So this might even take longer on here, because I actually want to make it look really nice. So what I'm going to do, instead of obviously talking throughout the entire building, I'm just going to make it into a big time lapse. Because, yeah, I don't really see any other way to do it, but hopefully you guys enjoy the time lapse. I know you guys probably want to see me talking through it, but I think it's going to be way too big of a build to talk through the entire thing, so yeah. I'm gonna get started building and try to make it look my best. Okay, guys, so like I said, this isn't the exact thing we saw in the creative world, but it uses the exact same color scheme, and it's just a general fountain. So actually, I am not gonna lie, I like this one better than our one in the creative world. I thought it was gonna be a lot harder to make one in survival than creative, but I like this one a lot better in my opinion. I think the water flows a lot better, the shape and the design is general better. Let me just grab these blocks. Yeah, I really like this one. This one also uses less material now. It's obviously very, very expensive still. We got 4 diamond blocks on this row right here, and then we got 4 diamond blocks over there, and we do have one hidden diamond block inside of the fountain because I am rich. So I just put a diamond block inside of there, but I really do like this fountain. I am generally very impressed with myself. You guys should tell me in the comments, so what do you think of the fountain? Do you think it looks ugly? Do you think it looks like a popsicle? Do you think it looks like just bad? You go ahead and tell me. You won't hurt my feelings, but I do really like it. Now, while I was building it, I actually thought of an idea I could implement. Let me just grab my stuff while I'm in here. So the idea that I was thinking about doing is actually adding in kind of like a wishing well type function. So putting maybe, let's put a torch right there, adding a hopper maybe right here, and then it'll pick up things as we throw them in there. Kind of like a wishing well, do you know? I'm sure most of you guys have seen a wishing well at some kind of mall, at a like a state park, or just a park in general. The only problem is, down here the water tends to flow very weirdly, and I've got all these blocks in the way. But yeah, so what I think I'm gonna do is add maybe, because generally I'm not gonna run up the fountain, go all the way up here and just chuck something. If I'm ever gonna throw something in here, it's gonna be probably at the edge right here. I think I put some hoppers on the parkour map, so we might go ahead and have to do the parkour map. Please don't be in a hard chest. Please don't be in a hard chest. Oh, it's this. You know, guys, you know what I'm gonna do? I know there was 2 hoppers in here. The problem is, oh, and there's one in here. I'm kind of scared to do that one, to be honest. So you know what I'm thinking? If we win this one, so we'll just have to do this one twice. Okay. So yeah, we're gonna have to do some parkour real quick, just so we can get some iron. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna take this stuff and I'm just gonna chuck it in here. Take my armor off. I really don't want to lose my armor. And let's go ahead and finish that parkour one twice. And then we'll go ahead, pick up our iron. We can go ahead and make some chests. So yeah, it's this one, correct? So what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to go down and back. And then we'll get 2 prizes. And then we'll be able to get both iron pieces. So let's try to do this one. Okay, bang, bang, bang. Okay, now please, okay. But the jump boost is about to run off, so you know what, we're gonna wait for the jump boost. But there is one. Alright, so we have 1 prize. Now we gotta do it. Gotta be careful on this one, because this one, it's gonna be a lot harder this time because I don't have jump boost. And I fell in. Oh no. But you know what, that is completely fine. Technically, we finished it once. We just have to finish it one more time, so we can go ahead and just get back in there. One more time, finish it with jump boost, because I've noticed it's a lot easier to finish it with jump boost. So we can just kind of jump in here. Can actually skip 2 of them just like that. Bang, bang, bang. 1. Just 2 more jumps. Bang and bang. There we go. And we can go ahead. I'm not going to even bother to do it one more time because I'm probably going to die. You can go ahead. Oh, I almost fell in the lava. We can go ahead and grab the 2 pieces of iron and head back. That is our prize. We can go ahead and make 2 more hoppers. This is actually perfectly planned. I swear I did not script that. That's actually a thing over here. So let's clear these. And we're just going to make a little pond. A little pond. Oh, no, I want that. I need that block right there. We're going to make a little pond that we can throw stuff in. So we're going to have to make it 2 deep, since I still want the hopper actually inside of water. What we're going to do, we're going to make the bottom out of quartz, like so. And then this spot is actually going to have to be a chest, like that. And then we're going to have to make a hopper on this one. And then we're going to have to replace all of these over here. So let's start replacing these, because of course we want to make it look nice. No, like, weird blocks at the sides. Hopefully I'll have enough quartz to finish. I think I will, though. More like that. One, two, three. We can actually put the prismarine around the sides. Actually, no, we can just put the andesite. The andesite is completely fine, and my dog is... Alright, so my dog was apparently having a really bad dream. I guess could probably hear her. She's sleeping right next to me while I'm recording. But let's get back to the actual build. Let's go grab some more polished andesite. Yeah, hopefully my dog is okay. That was weird. She only does that once in a very long time where she actually makes noises in her sleep. But let's make a little trimming with andesite just like that. Oh no, we didn't need this here. We accidentally messed up a little bit. We can go ahead and just put that there. That there, and just a piece of dirt. Let's make this a piece of dirt so the grass can spread, though. But yeah, and right here, I guess we'll just have a little pond going. Now, break this. Oh, no. Okay. Okay, guys, so I've played around with the water a little bit. I think I'm just going to leave it here, and then whenever someone goes by to throw something in there, let's actually throw something valuable. Okay, maybe some iron. They can actually just kind of throw it right in the middle, and generally it'll go in that. And if you miss, well, then you just got to pick it kind of back up and throw it back in there like that. But that's okay. So there's our little kind of giving center. But yeah, guys, I think this fountain is kind of done. This is going to be the final form of the fountain. And yeah, I really like it. So next up, we have not a very big project. But yeah, we're going to get to that in a second. I just want to clear my inventory up a bit here. Okay, let's just add like a third chest, and I'll clean this up a little bit later. Like so, and just throw this stuff in here. But next, we have to build a little armor dispensary, which is not going to use very often because, of course, I don't really need armor that often. And we kind of already have like armor stands. But I'm going to build a little armor dispensary just randomly, you know, just for fun. So for that, we're going to need lots and lots of dispensers, which I actually do have a bunch, which is very, very nice. What I'm going to need is a fence post. Like that. And I am going to need... I forgot how to make... Is it three or two? I'm pretty sure it's only two. Yeah, a wooden pressure plate. And that's really actually about it. They're very, very, very simple to make. So yeah, we have armor here, but honestly, I want to make the armor dispensary kind of over here. So how are we going to work this? I think what we're going to do is we're going to just put it right here. So we're going to do something like this, and then have... How are we going to do this? Do it like that, just like so. And then, yeah, I think that's really it. Obviously, now what we're going to do is place the fence and place this wooden thing. And then once we hit it, actually, all of these will go off, which is kind of cool. Now, what we actually have to do is fill these up with armor. So, again, like I said, it's going to be a very kind of small little cool project. But let's take... Okay, we're going to have to clear up our inventory a bit. Let's take this suit of armor, throw it back there. I guess we'll just kind of take everything. We can take all of these and just kind of throw them in there, and then it'll suit us up on its own, which is kind of cool. Now, I don't know if we have nine of each thing, but we have a good amount here. Let's take all of these. And I might keep like one armor stand here or there. Why do we have the iron? Oh, we can put that in there too. So yeah, we gotta dedicate each one for something. So let's just say this one, let's keep hats in. Because this one seems like a hat one. And this one, let's put pants. And this one, let's put, boots. And then this one, we'll put the actual chest plate itself. Okay, so now we actually have three more dispensers we can fill up. So what we can do with those is just put items we're going to generally need. So things like that would include a water bucket. We always need a water bucket. Let's take, you know what we're going to do? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We're going to fill these up with water in a second. Because anytime I go outside, I do want to bring a water with me, a water bucket with me. So I can just grab them from here, which is very, very nice. Instead of taking all the water, we'll just fill it up like this. Okay, so let's head back here. So we can make this back one. We can make that water buckets. We can make this one. Okay, so I made myself a lot of shields. Now, all these shields don't have something on them. That really doesn't matter if we're going into combat. So we're going to do... We're going to take the shovels out of there because, honestly, we're not going to need those shovels, to be honest. And, yeah, I'd rather have a shield because probably whenever I use that, I'm probably going to get into combat most often. So we can go ahead and put these two shovels back. Now, actually, I do have a chest for shields specifically, so we can throw this one in here. So, of course, we don't waste space. And I did grab some of the iron that we cooked up earlier. And the redstone, just like that. And now I'll actually show you guys what this does. Or, like, what it's going to do. Let's find an empty chest. Let's shove all our stuff in here, even the armor. So let's just say we're fighting something and we end up dying. And we need to get there back quickly. What we can do is just run over here. And, of course, I'll grab food before we go. Go into here. Hit this, and then we actually get all armor, we end up getting a shield which we can hold up, and we have a pick and a water bucket. And I actually just changed my mind one more time, thinking about it, if I'm going into battle, I'm probably not going to need a pick, so I'm actually going to replace those with swords, because that's what I really need, so I'll have a sword and a pick. There we go, and of course I'll have to refill this time by time, but that's completely okay. And yeah, that's going to be our little armor dispensary for now. Okay, now real quickly, before we leave this, I do want to make it look a bit better. So let's grab some blocks. What block would look nice? You know what? It looks a little out of place, but you know what? I think it's going to be fine. We're probably going to end up replacing it anyway later for a bigger, maybe better dispensary. So yeah, I think that'll be fine for now. Now, here comes kind of the bigger job for today is replacing brick with bone blocks. Now, obviously, I'm not going to replace literally everything with bone blocks, but there's a lot of things that I do, which I'll actually go outside and show you guys right now. So, as you guys know, before the bone blocks came out, I used a lot of stone brick because it was the easiest to get. Now, bone blocks are very easy to get, so I want to replace a lot of this stuff with the bone blocks. But some things I'm not going to, obviously, like this. This is going to be way too much work to replace the bone blocks, and I could replace just these blocks, but then it'll look kind of out of place. So things like this I'm just going to leave. The chicken farm I might attempt, maybe at a later episode. The thing is, if there's redstone involved, I really don't want to play with that if there's redstone involved. So I might end up just changing things like this villager house, maybe the egg farm and the snow farm. I might end up taking a few blocks out of here, so... Yeah, those are the types of things I'm going to do. I might do the cactus farm. The only thing is if I break the cactus farm, that's going to be a gigantic problem. I don't even know if I will mess with that. But some of these things I do want to replace. So guys, let me go grab some bone blocks. And I think I'll turn it into another kind of time lapse. I know today has been a lot of time lapses. But yeah, when I'm building, I really don't like... kind of want to concentrate when I'm building. But yeah, I'm going to go out, fix... maybe look, make some of the buildings look a little bit more pretty. Thank you. Well, you guys saw everything I did in the little time lapses, but I want to kind of go through them, obviously, while not in the time lapse. So I replaced a lot of things with that new bone block. And actually, before we go, let's take a sleep before we go, because I do think it looks better in the day. And by the way, guys, one thing I've noticed is that I do not almost ever use the dual hand function thing that came on 1.9. I'm still so used to playing normal Minecraft that I still use the one-handed, but you can already take a look. There's been a lot of changes. A lot of things have been changed to white. So I added this little white ring around here. Obviously, the entire fountain we built is white. I replaced the entire horse stables white, and I added a light up top. Every single one of these also has a light up top and just replaced with just bone. All this is all white now. It's all completely replaced. Over here, the entire cactus farm is replaced. The animals is not done, but I'll replace those for sure. If we come back here, I did replace this entire thing here. And again, I didn't finish the middle, but I did finish the sides completely all white. and there's one last thing that I changed, which is over here. But yeah, a lot of things were changed, but I think they look a lot better, to be honest. I'm glad I did this, and I'm probably going to do it to more things, even maybe like this. And I also fixed up this. This used to be just stone, and I kind of just made it look all pretty and added quartz. And I had a little bit of bone in here, so you guys can see the color difference. But yeah, that is kind of everything we did. So today we have done a lot in our world, actually. Probably not time-wise or content-wise, but building wise we built a fountain. I rebuilt most of my world, to be honest, or a lot of it. But yeah, I think sorry guys, today's episode might be a little bit short because there was a lot of time lapses and things like that, not actual playing and running around doing stuff. But yeah, today we did quite a bit. Well guys, I hope you guys enjoyed watching today. I had a lot of fun building and making new things in our world today. So guys, if you did, make sure to like and comment as it supports my channel, and I'll see you guys later. God bless, and goodbye.